최초선의 첫 수소탄 시험이 성공적으로 진행되었다.
Since the beginning of the year, North Korea has been provoking the world with nuclear tests and missile launches.
북한이 오늘 오전 동해상을 향해 단거리 발사체 여러 발을 발사했습니다.
새롭게 제작된 핵탄두의 핵 공격 능력을 높이기 위한 시험을 계속 진행하고
북한이 비핵화 의지를 보이지 않고 변화를 거부하는 한
Crimes against humanity threaten peace and security on the Korean Peninsula. For this reason, Reverend Sun Myung-moon and Dr. Hakja Han-moon have devoted themselves to the unification of North and South Korea and world peace.
국적을 초월해야 합니다.
레버런드 문's companion and partner on this lonely and righteous path is Dr. Hakja Han-moon. They have toured 180 nations over 40 years. They have met hundreds of thousands of people. Why have these two individuals undergone such a difficult course? Reverend Sun Myung-moon and Dr. Hakja Han-moon have worked to create a peaceful world for all of humankind as one global family. They have passionately overcome numerous difficulties with their sacrifices and peace ideology that transcends religion, race, and nationality. Why is Reverend Sun Myung-moon's name still known by people all over the world, even now, 4 years after his passing?
Peace 투입되는 남한의 항구 지역을 타격하는 것.
Peace and security on the Korean Peninsula is even more important during this time of constant nuclear tests and missile launches. The now vacant seat of Reverend Moon, who had extended a peaceful hand to North Korea, is now more unfortunate than ever. Reverend Moon's efforts for unification began to spread far and wide with the start of the Victory Over Communism movement for peace and unification in 1960. He began the Victory Over Communism movement out of a strong conviction that communism, which denied the existence of God, would collapse. The first nation that Reverend Moon focused on was Japan. At that time in 1958, Reverend Moon knew that the leftist forces expanding in Japan needed to be stopped. The speeches that Reverend Moon gave in Japan during that time resounded throughout the nation. Reverend Moon and Dr. Hakja Han-moon, who became the front runners of anti-communism and the Victory Over Communism movement, were never safe. This was before diplomatic ties had been established between Korea and Japan, and no one was accountable for their safety. After sacrificing their own lives to witness and overcoming trials and tribulations, their ideology began to gain recognition. No one ever imagined that they would hold a rally in Moscow during the era of the Iron Curtain, with communism standing as the strongest power. 600 prominent figures, including former presidents, prime ministers, and Soviet Union mass media, opposed the communist teachings and identified with Reverend Moon and Dr. Hakja Han-moon's ideology, as well as their courage. Communism collapsed because of their conviction, and Reverend Sun Myung-moon and Dr. Hakja Hanmoon held a historical meeting with Soviet Union President Gorbachev in April 1990. Such an exclusive meeting between nations with no diplomatic ties was unprecedented. On November 30th, 1991, they visited North Korea for the sake of North-South unification. As civilians, this was a difficult goal to accomplish, but Reverend Moon and Dr. Moon were not deterred by the ongoing hardships. No one would have ever guessed what Reverend Moon would say to the North Korean official, Mr. Yoon Ki-bok. Reverend Moon emphasized that true love centered on Godism is the key to resolving North-South relations, and that the unified fatherland must have Godism as its foundation. Reverend Moon had returned to his homeland for the first time in 40 years and discussed the development of Mount Kumgang, as well as the issue of families separated by the war, with North Korean Premier Kim Il-sung. He knew that only by embracing Premier Kim could he save the 25 million people of North Korea. It is important for the North Korean people to realize that the South Koreans are their fellow countrymen and women and feel this sense of national homogeneity. If they can feel that, then they will come to understand that political harmony must also be established. As non-governmental exchanges continued to develop, Pyonghwa Motors General Factory was built in 1998 in North Korea to spearhead economic cooperation. President Kim Dae-jung's groundbreaking visit to North Korea in June of 2000 allowed the Cold War state between North and South Korea to transform into a system of peace.
존경하는 문선명 총재와 각국 정상 여러분, 테러가 세계 도처에서 횡행하고 있습니다. 평화는 지금 더욱 악화되어 가는 상황에 있습니다. 우리는 이를 시급히 극복하는 노력을 해야겠습니다.
Unlike North Korea, nuclear powers such as Belarus, Kazakhstan, and the Ukraine disposed of their nuclear weapons for the sake of world peace after Reverend Sun Myung-moon and Dr. Hakja Hanmoon visited the Soviet Union.
Що Україна стає без'ядерною країною, що вона буде йти дорогою миру і злагоди. Вона стає позаблоковою країною. І ми вперше в світі склали ядерну зброю, будучи третьою за силою ядерною державою в світі.
September 2015, People's Rally for Peace and Unification.
심양홍입니다. 네. 여러분을 초대해서 통일로 한 발짝 더 다가선 느낌입니다.
Out of his desire for unification, Reverend Moon inaugurated the Citizens Association in 1987. Approximately 20,000 people from 80 cities and counties were appointed to the National Committee and promoted to the nationwide campaign. In the year 2015, which marks 70 years since Korea's independence and 70 years since its division, the government has been working hard to open an era of peace and unification. From that perspective, we expect the effort of the Citizens Association that is being developed in all 200 nations around the world to play a huge role in expanding the bonds of empathy for unification both within and beyond Korea. In the 60s and 70s, after the Vietnam War, the American values collapsed and the youth strayed toward alcohol and drug addiction. Reverend Moon and Dr. Hakja Hanmoon were very concerned about the confusion taking place in America.
미국 사회를 그대로 그렇게
Reverend Moon and Dr. Hakja Hanmoon knew that they couldn't leave the American society as it was and proceeded to move forward with their ideals. Only when a leader appeared who could lead America on the right path and raise the youth to guide American society can the international community move toward the path of a peaceful world. However, the mainstream society and the Christian Church taunted and opposed Reverend Moon and the Unification Church. Nevertheless, he became the icon of a spiritual revolution among the American youth and secured a stable religious foundation. He also met with President Eisenhower and stressed the importance of America's role in establishing world peace. After that meeting, Reverend Moon and his wife, Dr. Moon, held large-scale rallies in 70 different American cities from 72 to 1974. They held successful rallies in prime locations, including the Madison Square Garden rally in New York in 1974 with 25,000 people, the New York Yankee Stadium rally in 1976, and the Washington Monument rally with 300,000 people in attendance. At each rally, Reverend Moon and Dr. Moon's tearful messages of hope to properly establish America's founding ideals echoed in the hearts of Americans. In July of 1976, they became so prominent that they were featured on the cover of Newsweek. In addition, the New York Times reported that in 1970, Reverend Moon and Dr. Moon had begun to build a relationship with President Nixon and his anti-communist administration. In 1974 and 1975, Congress invited Reverend Moon and Dr. Moon to speak on the topic of One Nation Under God before Congress. These events gave them the opportunity to meet with other prominent figures. During the 34 years that Reverend Moon and Dr. Moon spent in America, they emphasized that America must not become a nation that lives just for itself, but become a nation that lives for the sake of the world. In January 2016, the Korean Peninsula, along with the rest of the world, experienced extremely cold weather, yielding a wind chill of minus 40 degrees. Global warming and the destruction of the environment has led to a food shortage that is resulting in the starvation of 1 billion people on Earth. Reverend Moon and Dr. Moon have exerted themselves to quickly resolve the food crisis that has affected third world nations. They aroused the desperation of native people in Brazil and Paraguay to escape starvation by living in those countries themselves, pioneering agriculture, creating farms, and participating in their labor.
Me llamó poderosamente la atención el trabajo del Dr. Gutka. Creo que es algo que nos va a servir a todos, en particular en el Paraguay. Paraguay es un país absolutamente opuesto en el planeta Tierra a Corea, en donde necesitamos alimentos. Y yo insisto en que la fábrica de peces, una piscifactoría, como le da llamaríamos en América Latina, es muy importante para poder alimentar y no solamente insistir en el ganado vacuno.
In 1980, Reverend Moon and Dr. Moon also began the CAUSA movement in South America in order to spiritually and substantially replenish isolated regions. Reverend Moon and Dr. Moon wanted to transform South America, so they held the International Leadership Conference in Montevideo, Uruguay, in which 300 leaders from around the world who empathized with their peace movement were in attendance.
Peace, a man of belief, and at the same time he was an important investor in the country.
Pero que sin embargo podíamos entendernos y compartir muchos valores fundamentales. Defensa de la familia, defensa de la convivencia de las religiones, defensa de la paz.
The threat of the armed group IS. Gunfire has not ceased in the Middle East for 70 years. It is a place that yearns for a helping hand that will cleanse the land that has been dyed with blood.
The unification members and coming from Reverend and Mrs. Moon had to do with this concept of parenthood and the concept of peace and somehow or another coming together.
For 10 years, starting in 2003, Reverend Moon and Dr. Moon held the Israel Peace March, an interreligious movement that sought to resolve religious conflict in the Middle East through dialogue. This historical movement tore down the walls of religion.
Dr. Moon, I understand, believes that UPF can serve as a peace UN to complement the political work of the United Nations. The UPF, I understand, will include representatives of religions, civil society, governments, and intergovernmental organizations in its governing bodies.
The Women's Federation for World Peace, founded by Dr. Moon, is an international NGO that received official approval from the UN in 1993 and continues to expand worldwide. Dr. Moon pioneered the path of peace, speaking on 600 different occasions in 100 different countries on the topics of leading with an iron fist in a velvet glove and understanding the preciousness of the strength of women. In 2005, UPF was inaugurated and raised its status at the UN to special consultative status with the Economic and Social Council. It aims to promote peace through service projects and practicing true love, which transcends families and nations. On February 14th, the Wanmo Pyonggye Foundation, founded by Dr. Moon in 2013, offered 2,000 student scholarships totaling 10 billion won. As desired by Reverend Moon, the foundation is becoming a bridge to help the youth of the world achieve their dreams. In order to spread his will, Dr. Moon is comforting these students and embracing their difficulties. As the peace ideology spreads, centered on Dr. Moon, the first Sunhok Peace Prize award ceremony was held in August 2015.
I pay homage to Reverend Dr. Sun Yung Moon for the ideals he stood for and his vision of one global peaceful family.
I applaud and honor the vision and the work of Reverend and Mrs. Moon. We should live for the sake of others and live as one family under God.
During a peace conference in Nepal in 2005, participants reflect on the unforgettable love and support they received from Reverend Sun Myung Moon and Dr. Hakja Han Moon.
Find you, Dr. Moon, amongst us at this critical juncture in our history. Your presence is in itself an assurance to us at a time when peace is in a peril and life of the people, Nepalese people, is in serious trouble.
On January 6th, according to the lunar calendar, an event was held to celebrate the birthdays of Reverend Moon and Dr. Moon. A message of peace was shared with the 30,000 people who attended the event, including 180 active National Assembly members from 50 nations.
The people gathering there from all over the world are seeking to strengthen the most important institutions and freedoms known to mankind. I'm encouraged by not only those who have been seen in the fight for religious freedom for years, but by so many who are stepping up to engage in this effort for the first time.
한반도 통일과 세계 평화를 위해 전 세계 40일 국제 지도자 컨퍼런스가 열렸습니다.
Our common goal is to work tirelessly for the preservation of peace and peaceful coexistence and cooperation with all nations of the world.
It is time for parliaments across the world to proactively engage in initiatives for the well-being of mankind and world peace.
The conference sought a resolution to the threat of North Korea through the teachings of Reverend Sun Myung-moon and Dr. Hak-ja Han-moon. 2 days later, on February 15th, the opening ceremony of the Peace Road 2016 was held in Imjin-gak, Paju City. It was a run for peace with 1,000 participants, including National Assembly members from 41 nations. The Peace Road movement is a global peace project that began in 2013 and completed its fourth year of connecting the world through a bicycle relay course under the theme of North-South unification, as well as the establishment of world peace. International marriage blessing ceremonies have been held since 1961 with the belief that happy families will ultimately build a world of peace. What started with 36 couples has expanded to thousands and millions of couples. This unprecedented marriage ceremony has also garnered much attention from the media.
삼천쌍의 합동 결혼식을 한다. 총재님께서 돌아가셨는데 여전히 이렇게 하는구나. 참 감사하게 생각했습니다. 이 세상 어떤 종교인이, 어떤 지도자가 세계인으로부터 그런 존경받고 합동 결혼식 참석하고 멀리서 가까이서 지 고하를 가리지 않고 전직 대통령, 국회의장, 총리 와서 축하하고 조문하고 그런 분 대한민국에 단 한 명도 없습니다.
It's a very high honor and a very great privilege for me to join this distinguished group of speakers and to participate in the Family Foundation for World Peace inaugural World Convention. But a parent's greatest legacy is his children, and God's people will truly become one family.
We should try to work out how families can achieve their purposes in a more flexible way, but with understanding and with the benefits which families have already had over centuries.
The International Marriage Blessing Ceremony transcends nationality, race, and culture with the understanding that we are all one human family.
Near about 15,000 couples were present, and they all got married there. And so far, I also remember that I also gave the speech at that time, and Father Moon was also Father Moon and Mother both were present at the function.
Reverend Sun Myung-moon and Dr. Hak-ja Han-moon have gone beyond religion and influenced many facets of society, including politics, economics, and culture. They have traveled all over the world, sharing the values of peace and true families. They have gone down this path because they know that only by transcending the differences of nationality, race, religion, and culture will we be able to achieve genuine global peace. They also hope that many more individuals will live as peace-loving global citizens. Reverend Sun Myung-moon and Dr. Hak-ja Han-moon's ideals of peace continue to this day. They have planted seeds of hope in the lowest places and embraced the world with true love. This is how we remember them.